If you're doing a job application, don't send over any Figma file until you've got these 8 things sorted. Everyone uses Figma now, and it's amazing. It's all web-based, so you can just send someone a link and they can jump right into your file. The downside of this is it means you're a bit under the microscope when you share files with someone. Obviously, when you're in the process of designing something fast, it makes sense to sometimes iterate quickly, not spend time making sure all your layers are properly structured and you're using components. But if you're sending over a Figma file as part of a job application, I think it's super important to make sure that everything is as neat and as tidy as possible. Not having these 8 things sorted wouldn't be a deal breaker, but it's all evidence that you've worked somewhere previously where this was important, that you take care in your design work, especially if you're working with other designers or contributing to a design system, and lastly, that you're able to hit the ground running with your design work. And unfortunately, given just how competitive the UX design job market is right now, these are the sort of things that could be a deal breaker and might give a company reason to choose one applicant over another. Also, I should say before we get into this that the idea for this video was suggested by someone who's watched previous videos of mine. If you do have ideas for videos, please do send them to me. I love to hear them and I'd love to make them. So, what are the 8 things that you have to be mindful of? The first one is page structure. Even if you're relatively new to using Figma, you should not be putting all of your designs on just one big page called page one. If you don't know how to set up your pages, here is a template that I use in all my new files. I basically copy this into all my files and then I delete the pages I don't need from here. And obviously some of these aren't relevant if you're using an external component library, which is linked into your file. But I think this is just a really good starting practice. So if you look in the description, I've left a link to a Figma community file where you can copy this and then you can use this to set up all your pages nice and neatly. Secondly is having a file thumbnail. If you're applying for a job and the recruiter has been sent loads of different Figma files and then they go back through their recent history and lots of them just don't have thumbnails and then yours stands out, you'll stand out way more. And if you don't know, making a thumbnail is super simple to do. You just hit F on your keyboard to make a new frame, choose the cover preset to get the right dimensions, and then right click on that frame and say use as file thumbnail. The third thing is having a dedicated prototype page. Now, prototypes in Figma definitely aren't a necessity, and most of the design work I've done hasn't required having a clickable prototype. But by having it, even if it's just a small flow, it's just an extra thing to show your interviewers or your recruiters that you're capable of doing this skill in Figma. So even if it's not the main part of the work that you'll be showing, having a simple prototyping flow is great for when they go snooping around through the rest of your file to make sure that you can show off your skills as a prototyper. The fourth thing is a big one, and it's definitely going to be contentious. It's naming your layers. Now, I don't think you need to name every single layer in a file, but I think if you have loads of rectangle 32141s going around the place, it just makes it look so messy. So my suggestion for this is just the top level layer in every frame. So everything under the main root frame should be named. So whether that's something simple like app bar, tab 1, tab 2, just whatever it is, make sure you're naming them. Fifth is an appropriate use of components and styles. Now, in my notes here, I wrote appropriate because I don't think every file should be using local components. Sometimes you've got a component library. Sometimes you shouldn't be using styles. You should be using variables. So whatever makes sense for the file that you're working on, you should be using it. The worst thing is if you don't have any of this systematic stuff in place. I think the sign of a good designer is being able to use systems properly. And I don't just mean design systems, but I mean thinking systematically. And having components and styles and variables throughout your file is a way to show that. And the sixth point, just on that note, is when you're using components, you should be using some of the more modern ways of designing components. So if you've got any local components, you should be using component variants, component properties. If you've not looked into what these are, I've got a great video that you can watch, and component properties are so simple to set up. Even if you've got any text layer in any of your components, you can turn that into a text property. Again, the point of doing all of this isn't because it's necessarily the best way of working in Figma. I know some people work really, really fast in Figma and don't use any of this stuff, and just still hand over a really good design file to their developers. But it's just another way to show off that you're on the road to becoming a Figma expert. Number 7 is auto layout. You should be using auto layout everywhere. If you're not using auto layout, you're not using the main superpower in Figma, because using auto layout just makes all of your designs way more consistent. It's so much closer to how all front-end developers code, whether they're coding native mobile or whether they're coding for the web. You should really be using auto layout. That's all I'm gonna say on that. And the last one is using frames instead of groups. This is such an easy one to look out for. When I've had to be part of interview processes and I've looked at people's Figma files, the first thing that stands out if someone is new to using Figma or maybe less confident with it is the heavy use of groups everywhere. Really, you should be using frames for absolutely everything. And if you're not, it's a sign that maybe you're not as advanced at Figma as some of the other candidates might be. So again, I've got a great video on frames versus groups, so go check that out if you're new to the concept of frames. But again, it's one of the main things in Figma that really makes Figma Figma. Awesome, so those were 8 things that I think you should do to every Figma file to make sure it's ready to send out to interviewers. If you're curious about getting that template of pages, I've left a link in the description so you can copy that page template with all the emojis all set up for you. Just before I go, let me say, please do hit subscribe if you like this video. I've got way more interview tips coming up, including a deep dive on how to do really well at case study interviews. So that's going to be really, really useful if you're looking for a UX job. I can tell from my YouTube analytics that most people watching these aren't subscribed, so I'd really appreciate it if you could hit subscribe and then you won't miss any new videos. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you on the next one. Cheers.